So we'll start the loop, and I'll increase the volume from 0 to 12. Now from 1 to 5, it gets marginally louder, but really from 5 to 12, it's just extra saturation until it gets really, really saggy. Good though. It's kind of the edge of destruction sound that these amps are known for. So I'll set it to 3.5. I'll put the tone down to 1. It gets a bit darker and a bit quieter. And as I raise it up to 12, you'll hear more gain as well as the treble coming back. Like a volume control for the active channel, even although there's nothing plugged into the normal channel. And there's the breakthrough. So even although the volume on the bright channel is at 0, you can still hear it. So it's leaking through from the unused channel. So there's actually a sweet spot with the volume on the unused channel being at the point where it just brings in the mid-range. And then dip out of that region again, and the mid-range comes back. So much gain that it doesn't make a lot of difference. Now I'll try the normal channel 1. The same characteristics. Except, on this channel you've got to be careful about the tone control because it's actually darker from 10 to 12. So the sweet spot for tone is below 10. So you can hear that going darker. It's not the same as the bright channel. Again, you can hear the bleed through from the unused channel. So all these controls are quite interactive. Exploding. So I'll go back into the bright channel one. This is a good setting. You get all the attack in the front end. It doesn't sag out too much. You still get the really, really great saturation. Okay, and that's the controls.
Thank you. Thank you.